Hello everyone. Welcome back again in this session of class 10 biology of class 10 chapter 6. Okay, now we are coming to the last topic of this session, that is one of the very important natural resource, that is coal and petroleum. First we will talk about coal. These two natural resources are, as I told you in the beginning, taking many years, millions of years to get prepared, because both are made up of the dead and decayed plants and animals on land and water respectively. So it's not practically possible to produce these coal and petroleum in factories and industries. Okay. So where we are using this coal? Coal we are using at many places. Like we are using coal in producing electricity. Earlier the coal was using in the train also, in railway engine also, to run the train. It is used at many places, in factories, in industries, to generate the energy, generate the heat, because coal contains maximum amount of the carbon, 98% of the carbon, so it helps to generate much more heat. Then petroleum and its byproducts, which are its byproducts, like petrol, kerosene, diesel, many other, these three we are using in the vehicles to run the vehicle as a fuel. Kerosene we are using at a domestic purpose also, in kerosene stove to cook the food. Then the byproducts such as LPG we are using in the, nowadays in every home we are using LPG to cook our food. So these two are very valuable natural resources which we are using since long period of time to make our life faster. But you know what, these both coal and petroleum are consumed so fastly. So what scientists say is that if at present rate of consuming, मतलब अभी जिस रेट से हम उसको कंज्यूम कर रहे हैं, what does it mean by consume? To consume means to withdrawn from the mines or withdrawn from the petroleum wells. You know that petroleum or this crude oil is taken out with the help of machineries through the well, because it is under the water, or and coal is found in mines. So the rate we are taking it out from the earth layer, it is devastating, means it is decreasing so rapidly. And scientists predicted that if at present rate, आज का जो rate है हमारा वो use करने का, consume करने का, उसी rate पे अगर हमने coal and petroleum का usage continue रखा, तो coal can be available only up to 200 years from now. And petroleum can be available only up to 40 years from now. Means you can guess, 40 years मतलब आप थोड़े से बड़े हो जाओ, मैं थोड़ी बूढ़ी हो जाऊंगी. Of course, I'll be near about 70 and you will be near about 50-56. So at that time there will be no petroleum in the petroleum wells to take out. And up to 200 years. See, if we are reducing the consumption, or if we are decreasing the rate of taking it out from the earth surface, from the earth, then it can be last for more years. Suppose isko plus 10 pakdo, isko plus 50 pakdo, so it can last for 250, it can last for 50 more years. Then also there is question that what next. So to use this sources judiciously, we have to go for some parameters, some options. What are that? That wherever is possible, we have to use alternative or substitute for this usage of coal and petroleum. Now what are these substitutes? See, India is a country which is lying nearby the equatorial region on the earth surface. What does it mean? It means that India is a country which get ample of sunlight, and that sunlight we can use in many ways. How? First, you can use solar energy to generate electrical energy. Second, you can use solar energy to cook the food by using solar cookers. Third, we can use solar panels on large scale wherever there is a need of large amount of electricity such as public places, hospitals, big offices, factories and industries as well. Then some small things like whenever there is no need, that time you should off the tube lights, bulbs, fans, televisions. Okay, if it is possible, then use the cold water instead of using hot water for bathing. If it is getting hot by the solar water heater, then it's okay. But as far as you are concerning with the usage of gas, usage of geyser, electric heater, then avoid it. Okay? Then what next? You can use the public transport instead of, see, suppose we five are there and we are going to the same office, right? Same office. Then instead of carrying five different or five special cars, we all can go in one. Or we can afford the public transport. Second, for short distance, suppose आपको यहाँ से ट्यूशन के लिए जाना है, आपको कोचिंग सेंटर के लिए जाना है, आपके घर से सरस्वती कोचिंग सेंटर में आ रहे हो, so this is not so far from your home, so you can prefer the bicycle instead of scooties or bikes. You can prefer the bicycles, which can save the fuel. Means ultimately we are saving this natural resource. Clear? Then whenever you are using fuel in any of the vehicle, make sure that your vehicle is in good condition. What sense? Good conditions means आपके गाड़ी का मेंटेनेंस रेगुलर होना चाहिए, आपके व्हीकल के इंजिन्स करेक्ट होने चाहिए. करेक्ट इन द सेंस वर्किंग इन विथ गुड एफिशिएंसी, अदरवाइज व्हाट विल हैपन, इट विल रन, नो डाउट इट विल रन ऑन रोड, बट इट विल कंज्यूम मोर एंड मोर फ्यूल. फिर आपको ही डाउट आता है मेरी गाड़ी का एवरेज ही नहीं आ रहा है, मेरी गाड़ी का एवरेज नहीं आ रहा है. एवरेज बहुत कम हो गया है. व्हाई दिस इज सो? एवरेज कम हो गया है इन द सेंस योर व्हीकल इज नॉट इन गुड मेंटेनेंस. So you need to do all these things. Apart from this, as far as possible for you personally, you can instruct your family members, you can instruct your neighbors, even you can arrange some awareness camp session so that people can reduce the consumption of coal and petroleum. Okay, now next we can see, in next session we will see what are the harmful effects of coal and petroleum.